What's up, coaches? Coach Career from General Gridiron. Today's episode is sponsored by All Out Apparel, my man Gene Levine. Check them out for all your coaching attire, uniforms, hats, embroidery, and screen print. Today's topic is going to be the differences between an eight-man front even defense and a pro-style even defense. Very much like the prior video that we did, there's things that differentiate them. Here, we may be able to get away with having a couple lesser athletes, where here we're probably gonna want more athletes on the field. This defense here, we're probably gonna play a lot of cover one, cover three. Here we're gonna have more variety of coverages. The difference, the big difference between even and odd structure is that, and why it appeals to me later now after 20 years of my career, and why I've been second guessing myself with this is, we don't have to get so scheme intensive when we're in the even front. You know where the four-man rush is coming from. We don't have to get to the four-man rush. Here, you can concentrate on building your five and six-man pressures more, where in the odd structures, we gotta have four-man pressures, calls for five-man pressures, six-man pressures, and even seven. Here, we're kind of relieved of that duty because we know where the four type players are. And I think the major difference between this and the odds, we need, where in odds we could get away with smaller guys in the interior because we're based on movement, slant and angle and speed. Here, I think we need bigger guys inside and we could get away with putting more athletic guys on the outside in either situation. The difference between here and here when it comes to the second level is these two guys need to be more athletic, I believe, than these two guys. These guys are more your plug types, inside guys. You don't want them messing around in coverage more. Here, you're gonna have to put some coverage on these guys. Where in here, we're gonna need probably a more athletic guy here, here, and here, plus your two corners. So you're probably gonna need a couple more athletes here to make this defense more successful. But like I said, the main thing is this defense, I think, is gonna be more predicated on playing gaps. Now, you can play two gap here, which I said, this ain't about that. This is more about the differences. We're gonna get to that at another point throughout the throughout our series of videos. Here, we're gonna play more of the gaps, okay? Here, obviously, it's very simple. Depending on how that plays, this guy's probably gonna have to play, first of all, let me not say that. The gaps will not be so clear. You're gonna have to play more flow. If ball's flowing this way, that's, you're gonna play more like that, and here's your support players here. Same thing here. If we get flow here, we're gonna have to play more, You can't have predetermined gaps. Yes, you gotta check your gap, but his ball's moving. For instance, if this ball is coming to this gap, he's gotta come, he's gotta relate inside. So it's more strategy involved with the way you play your interior. We have to play like if they were on a shoestring, and we want to make sure we get everything covered up. Now, here we're going to play on the back end more cover one or cover three because we're one high structure, where here we got the ability to walk him down and get to that eight-man box, spin him over, or we could play a two high, cover two tight deal, quarters, cover six. I mean, we got a variety of things we could do to disguise. And maybe I didn't say that well enough in the last video about what playing with these two guys does. It allows you to disguise a lot more things that you're trying to do. And you could present the defense more problems because you're not going to be so obvious. Where here, we're limited what we could do. Now, yes, we could move around these two pieces here and do some things, but it's nowhere near as versatile is what we could do here. And for that is the major difference between eight-man defenses and pro-style defenses, is how we approach the coverages and disguises because we have the ability to spin safeties down and move them. Now, in a perfect world, you would like two equal players here, but we always know we don't have it. So me, Coach Career, like I said, we may flip the safety to the strafe or have some calls that we get our better guys to one side. I don't think we're going to flip. We never have flipped the whole defense, but in either situation, odd or evens, we always have maybe two or three guys that would flip to the strength. We always have a couple adjusters that we may carry to one side of the field in a pod. But the main difference is what we could do in coverages. And we don't need as much movement from the front because we know where the four rushers are coming from. So it's a little less scheme oriented. It cuts down verbiage. And I believe it allows you to practice. You could practice this defense more efficiently because there's less things to concentrate on verbiage wise and scheme wise. So those are the major differences between a 4-4 and a 4-3. Or there's another variation out there, which I'm not an expert at, is the 4-2-5, but we will cover that later on in the future. I hope you guys get something from all of this. It's Coach Career. Until the next time.